Hey y'all, I'm back. It's your girl Krystal Brown, okay? / you don't even know me. Make sure you follow me on Instagram, okay? Today I am filming a get ready with me, okay? So yeah, I asked some of my friends on Instagram for some topics and nobody had no comments. I mean, I got one girl who's been following me for a while and I keep up with. And she mentioned two topics about a girl named, I can't even remember. Let me look. Her name is Tana M. I'm pretty sure a lot of you YouTubers probably know about her because she has a ton of subscribers. But I don't know her. You know? I don't know her. And today was my first time actually looking at her page. And what I can say from the little amount that I saw from her is she is a troublemaker and has a really potty mouth. I don't know. I mean, what I looked at was an apology. I'm sorry, I can't even find like my stuff right now. Okay, there we go. So what I looked at was an apology video that she... Let me turn that down. That she just posted not too long ago, and she was talking about how she apologizes and she's so stupid and she's so dumb for saying the N-word and just all of this other nonsense. And I'm like, how do you have all these subscribers with all this crazy stuff you're saying? But I guess if they like it, hey. But I mean, what I think about her apology, from what she said, yeah, about that. That's how I feel about that. So I'm just gonna skip over that topic because that girl, she's apologizing now, but I feel like she's those types, like she keeps apologizing just so she will keep her fan base or whatever. Even though she said, oh, I'm not doing this because I'm trying to keep my followers up or whatever. But if you, then why are you doing it? Just to say that I'm sorry to all your followers? It just doesn't make sense to me. Anyways, another topic was the Miss Mulatto and Young Lyric. Okay, again, didn't know who these girls were until today. From what I saw from Miss Mulatto and Young Lyric, you know, with the rappers, rap game and all of that stuff, I think they just do that for attention. Like, they plan it and say, oh, okay, we're gonna beef and stuff so people can, you know, we can attract the crowd and people like drama, so hey, you know? But I can say I am a fan now of Young Lyric. I like her. I think she kind of did it. She kind of shut up Miss Mulatto. And that name is kind of whack, sorry. But yeah, so with that being said, that's how I feel about those two girls. And they're really young. I mean, they're really good to be that young. They both rapping, you know, in the rap game. Let's see, what else I can talk about while I get ready. Oh, right now I'm getting ready to go see Get Out. And I'm really excited because I like mysterious, kind of like powerful movies. Because we all know he's going to get away at the end. Well, at least I think I know. But yeah, like, I think he's, so if you don't know about the movie or whatnot, the movie is about a black guy who was dating a white girl. And they go visit her family and everything. And everything seems cool and shit at the beginning. But, it's not too good. The grass isn't greener on the other side once he gets to the parents' house, you know? Chief! Sorry, my dog just walked out. I gotta get over here and sit down. He had an accident the other day, so now I have to keep an eye on him. Because he ain't listening today. He ain't listening. So yeah, my friend and I were going to the movies to go see this movie, see what happens. And so the parents play like they like him and everything. But little do he know, they got a trick up their sleeve. They're giving him like this tea that's supposed to like hypnotize him and make him feel basically out of there. But I saw some way, somehow, he had some energy to knock one of the people down. I don't know if it was a brother or what, but they had him in a chair. And all I saw was him, and the guy fell to his feet, to his knees. So yeah, I'm excited to see. We're catching the 10:45 show because my friend, she just got off. So yeah, I'm excited to see that. Everyone's been talking about the movie. I can't even think of the name of it right now. The guy from Speed. There is a 1 and 2. I guess this is the second one. Is it Hitch? Let me see. My sister texted me earlier. And John Wick. That's what it was. I'm over here talking about Hitch. Not Will Smith, okay? But, yeah, like, I heard that was a good movie. But, I don't remember, I don't think or recall that I've seen the first one, so I'm not gonna go see the second one until I see the first one, because then I'm just gonna be totally lost, which is no purpose at all for watching the second one if you don't know what happened in the first one. But, yeah. Also, I went to see 50 Shades Darker. I can say I liked it. I heard before I went to watch it that some people were like they didn't like it, and that obviously it's not going to be better than the books. They can't put all, like, they can't put too many like details from a book inside of a movie. They just don't have the time to do that. So I don't know why people expect for the movie to be exactly like the book. The movie is to shorten the book, to give you like an image instead of reading, because when you read stuff, you kind of have your own image in your head of, you know, with everything, of how the characters even look if they don't have pictures inside. I mean, even if they're talking about a topic or a place or anything, you're imaging it in your head a different way from how maybe the author is even trying to persuade it to you. So that's the whole purpose of a movie. But yeah, so I can say I really liked it. It was even just as intense in this movie as it was in the first one that I saw. So I was impressed. And this one was more, I mean, it had a little bit more going on, of course. I'm not gonna say too much if you can, because I don't know. I don't want to spoil it for the people who haven't seen it. But yeah. So if you haven't seen 50 Shades Darker and you're into that kind of stuff, you should definitely go see it. Let's see, what else I got for you? What else? I also like, I want to find a new makeup to start wearing. I mean, I love Tarte and all this stuff. My younger sister, she introduced me to Tarte, actually, because I have really oily skin, and I was like, hey, what do you use? Because, you know, she has, you know, dry skin, but I'm like, what do you use? Maybe I can use what you have on, because it was like matte. And she told me And I was like, you know what? I tried it and I fell in love with it, but I feel like I'm getting stuck, like, with the same things. I need to try new products and stuff, or maybe even create my own. Who knows, you know? But yeah, I've been looking into some labs and all that good stuff, because I think I've got the concept down with foundation, eyeshadows, and brushes. So hopefully I can get something going with that before I start the clothing line. But yeah. Another topic I wanted to talk about was Beyonce having twins. You know, I'm okay with everybody, you know, being happy for her and stuff. I mean, she's a celebrity, so of course people are gonna promote her pregnancy and all that good stuff. I mean, she's known. I mean, an average girl that, you know, have maybe 300 followers, everyone's not gonna post her pictures, her pregnancy pictures, because, I mean, not everyone knows her. So I'm pretty sure if they knew her, then they would be just as proud for her. So all these people saying, like, oh, they're giving Beyonce all this power and all this stuff, I don't believe in that. Like, that's not what I think, at least. I just think, like, more people know her, so of course she's gonna get millions of people memeing her and posting pictures about her pregnancy, congratulating her, you know? That's just the world we live in. Sometimes people just know. So how was everyone's week this week? My week was a little hectic because of work, of course. But hey, I got through it this week. I made it. I'm here. I still have a job. So yeah, work was crazy this week. I wish more people would have gave me topics to talk about, because I mean, I'm on Instagram a lot, but I'm not like, maybe I should go to the shade room. Oh my gosh, I know who I could talk about. Chris Brown and Karrueche. I knew I had something to tell y'all. Oh my goodness. This boy is crazy. Oh my gosh. Chris Brown, if you're watching, which you probably aren't, but if someone's watching and they know you, pass the message. I just want to say to Chris Brown, dude, you gotta wake up. You gotta wake up. Because the image you're giving off right now is like a psychopath. And I feel like you've lost control of your life. Like, you need to wake up and gain back control. And I just feel like the way he's living, like, I feel like he feels like it's okay. He's okay with it and it's fine. It's just who he is and all this stuff. But I'm like, no, dude, this is not who you were before. Like, maybe it was, maybe I'm wrong, but I just know from the way he looks right now, it's just, he doesn't even look like a celebrity. He's always going to be a good artist. No one can ever take that away from him. He's just talented in that area. He has an amazing voice. He has a gift to writing good music. Like, you know, no one can take that away from him, you know, because that's a God-given gift. But his sanity, yeah. And I heard that from Miss Wendy Williams, that Karrueche put a restraining order on him because he told her that he was gonna kill her. And I mean, I wouldn't believe that if he wouldn't have made that video with him with them braids. Did y'all see that? Oh my gosh. This boy. First of all, when the hell did he have enough hair to get cornrows? I'm like, I could have could have sworn your hair was just short. I could have sworn it was blonde. Now you have cornrows, and next you're gonna have a curl. So I just can't keep up. Like, I can't keep up. I don't even think he can keep up with himself. But you know what? I am still a Chris Brown fan because he's just a talented artist, and I love his music. And like I said, no one can take that away. But with this Karrueche stuff, dude, I don't know why he's so attached, but he's going to have to detach himself. There's plenty other mixed breed, Blasian, Asian, whatever you want to call her, out here. And I'm pretty sure, first of all, he don't even need to be focused on no girls right now. Besides his baby, you know, his little princess. And it's like, dude, do you see how you're acting with Karrueche? Do you want someone to act like that with your daughter? Like, I think he needs to see that. I don't know what it's gonna take. I just don't know. I don't know. Can we go back to 2003 when Chris Brown, was it 2003? I don't even know. But I just miss the old Chris Brown, who had a good head on his shoulder. And you know what? When they first broke up, it seemed like, you know, he was kind of, you know, coming out of it, kind of, you know, working on himself and all that. But then it's like, he just went ballistic. Then he having this planned fight with Soulja Boy, and I'm like, you know, if I would think Chris Brown would win if he didn't look so, I don't know, I hate to say this because I am a Chris Brown fan, but he looks, I don't know, like drugged out, like maybe too much weed or something. But even it's just his face, his eyes, you can look at somebody and they might not see it, but because they're used to the way they look at the time, but someone else from the outside looking in or looking at you, you can see a huge difference. And I see a huge difference in his face, and I'm like, Soulja Boy might knock you out, but you know what? I'm still gonna ride for Chris Brown. But you know what I mean? I don't know. I'm kind of excited though. You know what I mean? Even though it's probably gonna be a little boo-boo fight. Two or three rounds. But you know what? I'm gonna be prepared. I'm gonna have my popcorn. They've been selling tickets. Hold up. They're even selling tickets for this. You know what? And I'm kind of excited, you know? I want them to keep it going. Hopefully nobody pumps out or apologizes. We ain't got time for that. If you got beef, you got beef. Settle it in the ring. Don't be apologizing. Because, you know, we all gonna pay to see this. But yeah, besides that, I'm a big Chris Brown fan. I've never really been a Karrueche fan. I am a huge Rihanna fan. You know, Karrueche's cool, whatever. I've seen her a few times, actually. Super sweet girl, nice. And I really don't have anything negative to say about her. But I wish her luck on her career, whatever. And I hope Chris Brown can get over it and leave her the hell alone and worry about him, himself, getting himself back. Maybe he needs some Buddha, not even yoga. The girl said she tried to give him some yoga lessons. That didn't even work. So I don't know what it's gonna take, but I hope he wakes up pretty soon, because right now he's asleep. In my eyes. So yeah. So that was a good little topic there. Okay, so who else? Please don't forget. I'm not gonna wear no eyeshadow tonight. I might put a little bronze and something on there, but nothing too crazy. I'm really excited to see this movie though. Also, okay. I've been following this family called the Ace Family, and I absolutely love them. They are cool as shit from YouTube. I don't know them personally, but I really like them. And if you guys aren't following them, y'all need to. I mean, if you're young and you have a family, and they do like pranks and stuff, like I really like them. I also like I don't want to get their names wrong. Let's see. I think it's Dier. Let me see. I watched a lot of their videos, but I'm stuck on the Ace Family right now. At first I was stuck on this other couple, but I'm gonna see what's their name. Here she goes. Yeah, Dierra, and it's DK4L, and I've been following them, and I love them too. They do challenges. I love their film that when they went to Canada, and they were on top of a building, and they basically have these chains on their backs or ropes or whatever to keep them from falling off the building. But oh my gosh, I don't know if I could have did that. I think I would have rather have done skydiving, because what if that chain pops? You go. You ain't got no parachute. I mean, I don't know if they had parachutes, but I don't know. Bravo to y'all, because I couldn't get that one. But yeah, so back to the, oh my gosh, I am talking too much because the movie starts in an hour. I need to hurry up. It's at 10:45. But I am stuck on the Ace Family and their little baby Elle, Catherine. I love them. Austin's the father. I'm talking too much about them. You know, they're in competition with me. They have their YouTube channel too, and I have my YouTube channel. I'm supposed to be talking about myself, but you know what? I love them too much. Like, literally, when I'm at work, I watch their videos all the time, because one, I be bored sometimes at work. If I'm not busy, because sometimes I get busy and I can't do nothing. Especially if they say, we need this project out today. I'm like, God dang. You know what? But I love the people at my job. So, you know, I go ahead and I do it. I get it done. But yeah, I watched this video they did. They stayed in, they hit the 24-hour challenge. That was one of my favorite ones that they did. Besides the lottery ticket prank she did on him. But they stayed in Toys R Us for 24 hours. Poor Catherine. They were stuck in this little, they built this little, whatever you call it. They put these boxes and stuff around, these toy boxes, and they hid in there. I'm like, how did they not get caught? Because Austin was being so freaking loud. I'm like, they're going to get caught. They're going to get caught the whole time. But they didn't get caught. They were riding bicycles and everything. That was so fun. And then I watched another YouTuber do the 24-hour challenge inside of the jumping thing, jumping world or whatever. Oh my gosh, that was so cool. I think I would do that. And I'm like dying to do it. Like, I'm trying to get my boo into YouTube and stuff, but he ain't into that. He more of the work. He likes to work and get his stuff done, get his paper, get his money. You know, I do too. But you know, we gotta have a life. You know, we don't wanna, I mean, maybe we can have a life afterwards, but still, we gotta have a life. So hopefully me and him can do some pranks and stuff and a few videos. I'm gonna see what I can do for y'all. But yeah, I think I am almost done. I'm gonna do a little brown. Maybe I'm gonna get some Kai Shadow. somebody else just popped up in my head. And I really hate that she's like famous right now. Danielle. Yo, you don't know her by that. How about that? Yeah. Meet me outside. How about that? That girl. What the fuck? Wake up, world. Why is this girl famous? Why are we wasting our precious time on this girl in her potty mouth? I mean, my mouth's a little potty too, but I mean, not like that. This girl is just, there's no way I could disrespect my mom like that on television. First of all, my mom's crazy. She will, I call her out her name. Oh my gosh. My head is going out the window. I wouldn't even dare even try. You know? Get in there now. Over there. In your bed. Go in your room. Oh my gosh. This girl. I even hate to talk about her right now, but I'm running out of topics. So, you know what? Why not? Why not? Why not speak about how much I dislike her? You know, she's 13 years old. For one, I'm not hating on her. If she was doing something positive, yeah, okay. Oh, this is kind of pretty. It's like not too much, but just enough. But yeah, she's famous for being disrespectful to her mom. And I'm like, I know I'm not the only one. And I saw something about the Breakfast Club not wanting her to be on their show. And I was like, oh my gosh, thank God somebody else feels the same way I do. Because this little girl, I don't like her. And I don't like what comes out of her mouth. It's just, this is pointless fame. Y'all just gave fame to somebody who didn't deserve it. So, congrats on that, Danielle. But yeah, so about that. And I just, okay, so me and my baby boy and boo thing was talking about her too the other day, because we were like, she just had like literally like 14k and then it went to 66k and then now she has 5 million. I'm like, who in their right mind would follow her? I mean, I get it. She's saying everything that people will think. And I get it. I mean, you know, but it's just some stuff you just don't do. You just don't say. And I feel like, you know, if we're allowing her to be this way and say these things, and then we're teaching our youth to be that way, you know? And I'm part of the youth. I'm only in my 20s, in my early 20s. And it's just like, we don't want little kids to think like, oh, go and curse your mom out and it'll be okay. You can get fame from it. Like, why not? You think they wouldn't turn it down? Like, who doesn't want to, you know? Sometimes I wonder. I just wonder. I wonder why. Why? She's not a good example, and I really just feel like I cannot wait till her little 5 minutes of fame is over with, because she needs to move out the way and let somebody else step in and replace her. Someone that is positive and that's a good example, leading example. Not this bullcrap she's showing to our youth. I kind of want to do a peachy kind of lip. Let's see. But yeah, so, I don't know, I'm really upset about that. Sorry I had to let that out. Okay, so I need to hurry up because I literally have 40 minutes. Oh, my lips chapped. I need to get some lip balm. I just gotta line my lips. I don't know why. I just don't feel right if they're not lined. I feel like I'd be like, I'm so plain. I'm having these matte spray all week. I've been doing a quick look. I've been using this Flawless by Benefits. Oh my gosh, like, for work, I just put this on and do a little contour, a little bronzer with my old silk or contour palette and a little bit of highlighter. I don't even spray and didn't do a lip and I'm out. Like, that's it. I love it. But I feel like my lips are too plain right now. I forgot I got this from BeautyCon. This little ombre lip thing. I don't want to do, I mean, it's like a night movie. I don't want to get. Ooh. I didn't even put any Laura Mercier underneath my eyes. My finishing powder. You guys, let me forget. This is like magic. I can never forget about this. Okay. I'm gonna do a little bit. Sign up for the advisory at socalgas.com/advisory. Panda Pop. Mama Panda needs your help. Pop bubbles and help save the babies. With over 2,000 exciting levels, you can play anywhere. Panda Pop. Download now for free. I got some in my eye. This makes me want to go to like the bar in Washington and go potty. Should I do eyeliner? Where is my eyeliner? Where is my eyeliner? I can't go anywhere without Marc Jacobs, okay? Just a little bit. Get some flex. Don't you hate that face? Like, why can't we do it normally? So try to do it normally. I can't. Okay. Clean it up a little bit. I messed it up. That's how I danced in the club. Like, you might not believe me, but that's how it really go. Why isn't it messed? Why is it messed up? Oh, I messed up. I shouldn't put that mascara on. Freaking mascara. Don't get flexed. Don't get flexed. Okay, this one? Scandal? Yeah, it's a scandal. You know why? Because it's not good. Freaking got it on my eyes. Like, underneath my eyes. Okay. Okay. Hopefully no one noticed. All right, I'll be back to show y'all my little outfit, you know what I mean? Okay guys, I am fully ready. I'm trying to show you guys what I look like. Maybe I have to import some footage from Snapchat. I'm looking at my sneakers ready.